do for Jet.
Hi, knock off, hi, stop. Stand up.
Lieutenant, I hope your coming means that the government is going to give our railroad some protection.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm detailed to round up a group of thieves that took some horses from the remount station down at the fort.
Yeah, and while you're catching renegades, all us railroaders will lose our hair.
Oh, I know you're doing the best you can, Lieutenant. We're mighty grateful for what you've already done.
Thanks. I wish I had men to spare.
Well, don't bother to explain to me, but I do wish you'd send a man down to our construction camp to explain to Mr. Hartford. In the meantime, we'll try to get this timber down to the bridge.
I'll do that, Ramsey. Orderly, have Sergeant Brown report to me immediately.
Yes, sir.
I'll send Brown down to construction camp, and in the meantime, we'll take care of these Indians.
Thank you. Dex, what hit me?
I don't know. Any one of them little sticks would have been enough.
Blade are back.
Tell him to come in.
You know, Chief, we were just...
I know what happened. You struck too late, as you usually do. Ramsey had word of your coming and naturally was ready for you.
We didn't know them soldiers were coming.
Had you obeyed orders, Ramsey and his crew would have been wiped out before the troops got there. And you, Snake Eye. I depend upon you to keep the Indians active. I pay you well to bring about the destruction of the railroad. And what do you prove to be? Just a stupid coward. Take your hands away from that knife. Now get out, the both of you.
Better let me take care of Snake Eyes. You'll make trouble.
That's it. I still have use for him. I showed you that he didn't dare pull his knife.
Not while you're looking at him, no. Wait till your back's turned.
I've got to take the chance on that. We've got to strike a decisive blow. Have we a dependable man in the construction camp?
Stark is still there, and unsuspected.
Stark! You've got to put more speed in your work.
There's a trooper coming.
That's fine. We wait months for protection from the Indians, then the government sends us one man.
Mr. Hartford?
Yes.
Jeff Ramsey reports that he'll be delayed in getting the timber to that bridge job on account of trouble.
Indians?
Yes, but a detachment of our troops arrived in time to drive them off.
This never could have happened if Colonel Barnes had listened to me. I told him these Indian attacks were inspired by white men, or I should say a white man, King Carter of Black Hawk.
I'm sorry, sir, but our hands are full. There's nothing we can do about your suspicion.
Well, there's something I can do.
I hope so, sir. And as soon as we can spare troops, we'll send them to you.
Yeah.
Well, what do we do now?
I have a plan.
What is it?
I'm going over Colonel Barnes' head to get protection. I'm going to wire Senator Dodson to take the matter up to the Secretary of War.
Aren't you afraid that your message might be read before it gets to the telegraph?
I'll have Jeff take it over to the telegraph station just as soon as he gets back.
Well, why wait for Jeff? I can take it myself on the afternoon stage.
What would Jeff say if I told him you'd gone on the stage?
Oh, what difference does it make? Look, Dad, Jeff may be a good engineer, but there's no reason why he should dictate every move I make.
No, but...
That message to Senator Dodson is important. Now, the quicker it goes, the quicker we get protection from the government.
Maybe you're right. Captain Jarvis and his troops in this vicinity, the stage route should be safe enough.
Well, hurry it up, Dad.
Hello.
Stark says Hartford's sending a report to Washington in order to get troops.
Well, that had to come sooner or later. But we've got to stop that message. Who's going to take it?
Miss Hartford. Stark says she's leaving the construction camp on today's stage.
Find out if there's any passengers planning to go east. If so, persuade them to wait till the next trip. Understand? You and the boys are to stop the stage. You'll have only Lacey and the guard to deal with.
Are you sure Joe and Gus will be inside as passengers?
Certainly. Now get moving. The stage will be leaving any minute now.
Glad to have you along, Miss Hartford. A couple of gents inside to keep you company.
Don't worry, Dad. We'll get through all right. Then we'll have the laugh on Jeff Ramsey.
Looks like you're in for a pretty tough journey, miss.
I guess I'll survive it.
Well, I sure hope so.
Hartford got any promises out of that cavalry outfit?
I hope so. Otherwise, he's liable to go off half-cocked and start something that we'll have to finish.
Yeah, him or Claire. Man, that gal can send trouble further and head for it faster than any critter I ever see.
Yeah. Well, let's hurry up. Maybe we can get back to camp before dark.
On your horse, Logan.
Mm-hmm.
sister. Here's where you get out.
This is indeed a pleasure, Miss Hartford. Won't you sit down? Oh, I'm sorry.
This is going to get you into a lot of trouble, Mr. Carter.
On the contrary. I think your visit here will remove most of my difficulties.
What do you want?
That message you're carrying to the telegraph office. Thanks for telling me where you keep it. Will you give it to me? Or shall I have one of my men take it from you? Be sufficient evidence for your father to know that I'm holding a prisoner here. And now I'm sure he'll reroute his railroad through the Red Hills instead of my property. Lock in that room, Tim. Come with me, Snake Eye. Get the horses out of sight and keep a sharp watch. I'll be back in the morning.
Houston, now you keep quiet. Don't shoot till they're close in. They're both fast as lightning on the draw.
What happened?
I got the coach. And Miss Hartford was in it.
Miss Hartford? Which way did they go?
I don't know. They said something. Hi, Dad.
We better get him to camp and have Doc fix him up.
I tried.
Fred, we're too late, Tex. He's done for. Let's take a minute and come back and try to pick up the tracks of that coach.
In my own way, and I want him taken alive.
Nobody can take Ramsey alive. He's too quick with gun. Besides, he followed track to hideout.
Of course, but they won't get there before dark. So you get there ahead of them and set a trap. And remember, I want Ramsey taken alive.
Wait, no shoot.
Chief want Ramsey capture alive. One of you men watch from each side. When you hear them coming, give the owl signal.
I don't make war on women. And I'm going to risk my life to give you and Ramsey a chance.
Jim, where is he?
He's picked up your trail and he's headed this way.
Alone?
Shh. Yes. Now, they plan to kill him just as soon as he comes into this cabin. Unless you...
Unless what?
Well, Stand at the window where he can see you and warn him. I'll manage to get you away later.
Snake Eyes Camp.
That owl wears pants.
Yeah, and totes a gun. Wait here.
I think I hear him.
Drop that gun.
We got you covered.